हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ अहेर डी आर फ्रॉम RBNB कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर। टुडे आई डिलीवर ए लेक्चर ऑन थर्मोडायनामिक्स। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडी अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ द सिस्टम्स, ओपन सिस्टम, क्लोज सिस्टम एंड आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम। Today we study about the heat. Now if we consider a water is poured in the glass, and this glass is on the top of the table. This water is our system, and except water, all other things, means glass, then top, all are environment or surrounding. Now if we consider temperature of system is given by TS, so we write TS is the temperature of system, and TE is the temperature of surrounding. This surrounding is also called as the environment, and that's why we write TE is stand for environment, and therefore we write TE is the temperature of the surrounding. Now if this TS and TE are not equal, then in that case heat transfer, and always remember that heat transfer from a point at higher temperature to the point at lower temperature. Now if this TS is equal to TE, means temperature of system is equal to the temperature of surrounding, then both are at thermal equilibrium and there is no transfer of heat. Now if TS is not equal to TE, in that case if we consider this water as a system, and other than water, that is surrounding, if surrounding is at higher temperature, then if environment is at higher temperature than this system, means we can say that temperature of environment is greater than temperature of system, then in that case what happened? The heat is transferred from surrounding to system. In that case heat did transfer from the surrounding to system, and in that case this Q amount of heat energy is positive. Amount of heat energy is positive. Now remember that when heat is transferred from surrounding to system, In that case, system gains the energy. In that case, system gains the energy. And that's why the heat supplied by the surrounding to the system is positive. Now, in another case, if we consider same system, and temperature of system is greater than the temperature of environment. Now, in that case, heat is transferred from system to surrounding. Heat is transferred from system to surrounding. Now, in that case, the amount of heat energy Q is negative. So, always remember that when heat is transferred from system to surrounding, in that case, temperature of system is greater than the temperature of environment, then Q is always negative. Now, in this case, system loses its energy. System loses its energy. Now, if we consider another example, in that case, system and surrounding both are at same temperature, means temperature of system is equal to temperature of environment. Now, in that case, as both having same temperature, means system and surrounding both are in thermal equilibrium, there is no transfer of heat between system and surrounding. So, from these three examples, we can say that always heat flows from a point at higher temperature to the point at lower temperature. Now, if we consider the surrounding, if the surrounding is very large, if surrounding is very large, in that case, this TE is not measurable. When surrounding is large, always remember that when you consider surrounding is very large, then this TE is not measurable, but it is also not equal to zero. It is not equal to zero. So remember these two conditions. When surrounding is very large, then in that case TE is not measurable and also it is not equal to zero. Then we study this. In first case, Q is positive. In second case, Q is negative. And in third case, as temperature are same, therefore it remains in thermal equilibrium. Now, in these two cases, system and surrounding are at a different temperature. System and surrounding are at different temperature, and therefore there is flow of energy from a point at higher temperature to the point at lower temperature. And from these two examples, again we can say that heat is the thermal flow of energy between system and surrounding at temperature difference. Means when we consider temperature of system and temperature of surrounding, both are at different temperatures, and therefore there is flow of thermal energy from a point at higher temperature to the point at lower temperature. So we study about heat, and always remember that heat always flow from a point at higher temperature to the point at lower temperature. Now we have to study about the internal energy of a system. As we know that internal energy means the energy associated with molecules of the system, that energy is called as internal energy. That energy is called as internal energy. Now we have to study the change in the internal energy. We have to study the change in internal energy. Now for studying the change in the internal energy, we consider a cylinder and that cylinder having massless, movable, frictionless piston at the one end. And so we draw the diagram of that cylinder. In that case, this is the movable piston. It is a massless and frictionless. That's why this friction can move inside the cylinder and outside the cylinder. Now, if a gas is enclosed in the cylinder, now this gas is our system. This gas is our system. And remaining part of that cylinder, means cylinder and piston, all are its surrounding. Now, at initial state, the temperature of gas enclosed in the cylinder is say T1, that is equal to 100 degrees Celsius. Now we have to study the change in the internal energy of a gas which is enclosed inside the cylinder. And this change in the internal energy is by two ways. Now we consider first way. In first way, we change the internal energy by increasing the temperature of that cylinder when the cylinder is placed on the burner. This is the initial state when it is near the burner. Now what happened? In that case, the temperature of surrounding is greater than the temperature of system. So TE is greater than TS. TE is greater than TS. Temperature of surrounding is greater than the temperature of system. As temperature received by the gas molecules, then in that case, as thermal energy is received by the gas molecule, then its kinetic energy goes on increasing. And as we know that this kinetic energy is directly proportional to temperature. And that's why if we kept piston constant, position of piston is kept constant, then in final state, if we kept constant that piston at this fixed position, position of piston is fixed. So, due to the intermolecular energy, temperature of gas inside the cylinder goes on increasing, and in final state, its temperature is 200 degrees Celsius. So, In this case, we kept constant position of a friction. And as position of friction is kept constant, then the temperature of gas goes on increasing in final state, and there is increase in the, or there is change in the internal energy. There is, in this way, there is change in the internal energy. Also, in vice versa, if you consider the temperature of gas is large in initial state, and if we less the temperature, if we cool the gas, and position of piston is same, then also in that case there is also change in the internal energy. So in a first case, we change the internal energy by heating it. We heat the gas which is enclosed inside the cylinder, and position of piston is kept constant. Then there is change in the internal energy, and due to that there is increase in the temperature. Now in the second case, we also change the internal energy. Now in that case, if we take same gas inside the cylinder, and that cylinder having one piston at one end, this piston is movable, massless and frictionless, and that's why this piston can move inside and outside easily. Now in initial state, position of piston is at that position, say A. If we compress this gas suddenly, then piston moves inside the cylinder, and this is the final position of piston, say this B. If we compare the initial position and final position, then in that case this distance is very small, this is dx. As piston is compressed inside the cylinder, then gas get compressed, then again in that case temperature of gas goes on increasing, and therefore internal energy of a system also goes on changing. So in this way, the change in the internal energy can be changed by two methods, or both these two methods. In first method, change in the internal energy is due to the heating the system. In second case, if we move the piston inside or outside, then there is also change in the internal energy. Now from this diagram, we can say that the change in the internal energy is related with change in the internal energy, or this change in the internal energy is related with the heat. So this is about the change in the internal energy. In today's lecture, we study what is heat, and also we study about the ways by which there is change in the internal energy, and that change in the internal energy are, in first case we can say that there is change in the internal energy due to the heating the system, and in second case there is change in the internal energy due to the changing the position of piston. Means in first position, piston is moves inside the cylinder, then gas is compressed. If piston moves in outward direction, then temperature of gas goes on decreasing, gas gets cool. So in this way, there is change in the internal energy of a system. Today we stop here. Thank you.